2006 World Championships first round match already in progress. Vasyl Federation of Ukraine leads Sukhee Sukhbatar 1-0. Federation, one of the greats at this weight class, would go on to win two world medals and an Olympic silver in 2008, and he leads. Sukhee's got to find his way to some offense. Elbow control for Federation, trying to slow Sukhee down. Sukhee got to get some points. Looks foot sweep. It's not there. He's got 5 seconds to score. And Sukhee goes ankle pick. Gets back exposure. That's 2 points. As time expires, Sukhee takes this first period 2-1 over Federation.
Hi.
Sukhee. Hi, guys.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, Jaggi, you're still here. Okay. No baby yet.
No baby yet.
Not yet.
So today we're with Sukhee. Sukhee, one of our missionaries from Mongolia. And it's a pleasure to be here with you, Sukhee. Thanks for taking the time. This is me and David Mackay. We're meeting with him. And it's great to each week we interview one of our missionaries, and usually we just get a little bit of time, but this gives us a chance to talk more about you and your family and what you do. And so thank you for being one of our missionaries. Sukhee, how did you become a missionary?
I received the Christ in 2000 year when I was 19 years old. Mm-hmm. So that time as I was the our Mongolian freestyle wrestling national team member. So since that time in our sport world, there's almost not any Christian which who I know. Mm-hmm. So when I retired my wrestling career in 2008, so I was dreamed about somehow, some way in the Mongolian sport world that some Christians staying in the sport world and help the athletes and coaches. So that time I met with one, the American missionary who was living in Russia for 16 years, whose name is Stephen Baird. So he just departed from Russia, and he visited to Mongolia for a short to a mission trip, and he asked me, how about you and I started again, Athletes in Action Mongolia, the sport ministry in Mongolia. So right during that time, I was working in the marketplace in private company. No, sorry, in the government company. And then I decided several months ago, discussed with my wife, and I decided, yes, to join AIA full-time ministry in Mongolia. So usually in the Christianity came to Mongolia for 1990, right after the Soviet system fell down. That year was the right after 1990, there was the less than 5 Christians in Mongolia.
Wow.
Yeah, but now it's over 100,000 around, including kids, I think.
Wow, that's like less than 30 years, from 5 to 100,000.
Yes, it's an incredible number.
So I want to ask you a little bit about your wrestling career. I think we have a video of you taking down that Ukrainian man to win the first round of your 2006 first round match.
So my highest result is the third in the Asia, the bronze medal in Asian Championships, and several international tournaments.
Sukhee, is a lot of your ministry directed towards athletes and wrestlers, or are there some other people you reach out to as well?
Yes, my main focus is the people of the sport world. Mm-hmm. And also the sport ministry is also a very new concept in Mongolia. Mm-hmm. Because of the influence of the Soviet system, the communist system, sport was the propaganda for the community propaganda. So that's why average people thinking sport people is just like I would say only the pro people, some kind of the crazy kind of something like that. So but we're trying to reach out the communities. Sport is one of the best way to reach out the communities. Mm-hmm. And that's why we're trying to teach and encourage the local church, local communities also how to reach out the communities through this sport.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And what type of outreach activities do you teach these churches to do?
We teach them what is the sport ministry. It's not just gathering the young people and play with them. So after that, how can we be discipling them? It's not have to be through the mass, but one by one, especially how can the local church understand the people of the sport? Mm-hmm. Our the schedule, we're a little bit different. So I encourage the local leaders, local church leaders, how to reach out the athletes, people of the sport, and also discipling them. And in other ways, also through the kids, any the activity, kids game, we call it the kids game, and any other activities. And through the programs, we can reach out the, especially the in the new area, not many Christians, mostly we using the kids game, kind of the kids activities, we organizing the kids activity, then we reach out the local communities, inviting the people and share them gospel.
And the last time you were in Laramie, you mentioned that you were going to meet with people from FCA as well. Did that happen?
Yes. In Mongolia, not many sports the ministries for now. So during 2018, when I was in Laramie, I was the charge the FCA Mongolia too, in Mongolia. So yes, I was the charge AI Mongolia and also FCA Mongolia, mm-hmm. the times. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but now no more FCA yet.
That's really great. What are some challenges you've seen in ministry over the last few months?
Few months. Of course, the COVID, it's too crazy. Mm. Everybody's shocked and what's going to happen, what are we going to do? And so another challenge is especially from last year, I'm hired the 2 full-time intern in AI Mongolia. So it's my responsibility. In Mongolia, the rule of the Mongolian camps crew. So you know, the athletes in action is I'm under the crew Mongolia. So we have to, through the crew rule, the interns doesn't allow to raise any fund. So it's my responsibility to raise all of the fund and the ministry fund and also the monthly salary, etc., everything.
Yeah. You have to raise all their support.
Yes, so I it's my charge. So after they become join the staff, full-time staff, it will be their responsibility to raise their own support.
What are some maybe exciting things that have happened in your ministry over the last few months, year, or something like that?
Yeah, biggest thing is my main concern is not raising the full-time staff, full-time interns. So my main focus is to raising the volunteers. The volunteers, whoever, and where are they? I trying to teach them, trying to coach them how you can be the man of the God in where you are. So especially if you are the coach in the high school, if you are coach in the college, if you are athlete in national team, if you are the local church leader in your community, how can we using all of our talents and resources, and how can we multiply our the resources, all of our staffs, and so it's working on it, and it was the very exciting things for me. Yeah, I have several also good testimonies also here.
And Sukhee, you and Jaggi are also quite involved in translation work. Is that right? Like, you've translated many classic books.
Yeah, last 3 years, around 3 years, especially my wife Jaggi translated over the 10 books. And even after I joined the Camps Crusade, the Athletes in Action, step by step, day by day, I am very convincing, I would say. This is we need to educate the Christians. We need help them how our faith works, not just in us, in everywhere where we are. So that's why we need to educate, and that's why we need more the materials. So, you know, last 30 years, the Christianity still is new concept for Mongolian society, and we need more the materials, good books, good materials. Yeah.
Like, what sort of books have you translated recently?
Right now, my wife is ready for birth. That's why she can't sit very well. So that's why I'm working on the Dr. Henrik Lau's Change That Heal, the book. Yeah. And in this book, of course, the main concept is the boundary also. So is that how do we set the boundaries for us, for everybody, kids, wives, spouses, and everything. So it's very, very new concept. And also my wife and I was very strongly concerning the crew have the family life ministry. It's the very new ministry in Mongolian crew also. So Jaggi made all of the series of the family life ministries. It's the Bible study materials and how to raising kids and all of this. Yeah, Jaggi is working on it. And also we last year we finished the how to use the sport to glorify the God. What does that mean, the glory God? After athletes mostly use the lots of the kind of stuff, but what does that really mean? The glory, give the glory to God. And it's also the general, it's the training resource, mostly the materials have to use the sport to reach out communities. There's lots of the practical ways. It's published by the Internet Sport Coalition. So we translated and published these books also. Yeah.
Those are great, Sukhee. We've used some of that same material in our church for marriage conferences, and we use family life things. We've even been watching some of their videos and live stream things for the quarantine. So we're doing the same thing here. That's great that you're doing that there. You mentioned your wife is pregnant. David told me that. Maybe tell us about your family a little bit, and you're getting ready to add a new person to the family.
Yeah, we have showed first of our video, and we have three kids now, and the fourth is on the way. We hope very soon. And now we're waiting for our baby number four.
Can you introduce all your kids again to us?
Yeah, my oldest son is, full name is Inghorstlung, but American friends call him WP. And my youngest, the daughter is her name is Gigi. In English name is Gigi. And the third is the son boy, and the Murum. His name is Murum. And the fourth, we have not officially given name yet.
Yeah, that's great. Any other stories to tell us, Jaggi or Sukhee, or any other information you want us to know?
Especially your church is a very, very important for starting the EIA in my EIA Mongolia, because when I was starting just Athletes in Action Mongolia starting in 2010, in our very first Athletes in Action Mongolia wrestling camp, there was the Steve Suter was in our camp, and he was one of the main coach of our camp, and also he shared with all of the athletes and coaches. There was Mongolian, American, Inner Mongolia, who's from China, and also Buryatia from Russia, four countries. And Sudhir was in our camp, and his involvement and was very big encouragement for me. And it's also was become very encouragement for me how using our talents for his glory. And I just remembered about it today morning. And Sudhir and Diana has very big impact for us.
I still remember meeting with you in Las Vegas at the World Championships the EIA room, and you and Barrett and Sudhir and David.
So it's not-
It was so good to see you.
Yeah, there was Mongolia was did very good result, and the Mongolians fans was maybe number two fans after the USA. There was lots of Mongolians. Mongolians men's and girls team was did very, very good job.
That's so good. So is there anything we could pray for you about? Sukhee, David and I will pray for you tonight, but is there anything you'd like our congregation to pray for you?
Yeah, biggest prayer request is Jaggi. They burn well, safety well, burn. And yeah, that's it.
Any day now, right? She will have the baby.
Yeah, yeah. Any day now. It's ready. Everything's ready. Okay. If you say, let's go, I'm ready.
Okay, great. Would you like to pray for him, David? That would be
sure.
Be great.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your goodness to us, how you are sovereign over the whole world. We thank you that you made the connection with Sukhee through Stephen to us. We continue that, and we pray for Sukhee and Jaggi for a safe and healthy baby, for Jaggi's safe delivery. We pray that everything goes smoothly. We pray that during this time of the virus also that they can continue to be effective servants for you. We thank you for the example they are to us and the privilege it is to join them in their ministry. We give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Oh, so good, Sukhee.
Yeah. Thanks so much, Sukhee, for meeting with us. It's great. David keeps me posted on your wrestling and what's going on there. And it's just great to be your friend and to watch what's going on, what God's doing through you.
Thank you. Thanks for your time. Mm-hmm.